Welcome to the lesson on factoring methods. Let's take a look at this first example here, which is a quadratic trinomial in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c. Now, if we take the ac term, 6 times negative 10 is negative 60, and we write down the b term, which is positive 7, these numbers are going to help us figure out how to factor the trinomial. We go through the factors of negative 60 to see what they add up to be. Negative 1 times 60 is 59. What we want it to be is a positive 7, so that didn't work. Negative 2 times 30, that adds up to be 28. Negative 3 times 20 adds up to be 17, so we're definitely getting closer. Negative 4 times positive 15, those add up to be 11. Negative 5 times positive 12, now that does add up to be 7. That's what we were looking for. So these are the two factors that we want to use. Now, the way we use these numbers is that it tells us how to break up the 7x. We take the 7x and we turn it into minus 5x and plus 12x in either order. Okay, we could have put the 12x first and the minus 5x second if we wanted to. Now, the first term, 6x squared, comes straight down. The last term, minus 10, comes straight down. Those are unaltered. Now what we're going to do is, two at a time, factor these four terms. So we've got these two that we're going to look at first, and we see that what they have in common is just an x. That's the only thing those two have in common. So we factor out the x, and we have left over 6x minus 5. Now we look at the next two terms, these two right here, and we see that the only thing they have in common is a 2. And what would be left is 6x minus 5. Now we notice that each of these has a 6x minus 5 in it. So now we are going to factor that out, and we get 6x minus 5 times what's left, which would be x plus 2. And that is the factorization. Now we should always double check our answer, at least by mentally foiling back out. We know if we have first times first, that would give us the 6x squared. We know outer times outer would be plus 12x. Inner times inner would be minus 5x, so 12x minus 5x would give us that 7x. And then last times last gives us the minus 10. So we feel really confident that we've factored this one correctly, and indeed we have. Part 2, example B, where we're going to look at how to factor the difference of two squares. So let's jot down a couple rules from algebra that we're going to need. We know that a squared minus b squared factors to be a minus b times a plus b. Now another rule that we're going to need to use is what happens when you take a power to a power. So if I have x to the a, and I raise that up to the b, that equals x to the a times b. So we're going to use both of these rules in order to do this factoring. Because the first thing we have to do is take what we have right here, the 16x to the 2 fifths minus the 9y to the 8th, and get it into the form of a squared minus b squared. So the way we can accomplish that is we write this first term as 4x to the 1 fifth squared. Now let's review. 4 squared would give the 16, and x to the 1 fifth squared would be x to the 2 fifths, because remember, what we're using here is taking the power to a power. X to the 1 fifth to the 2 means we would take 1 fifth times 2, which is 2 fifths. Okay, now we're subtracting away 9y to the 8th, so we can write that as 3y to the 4th, that whole quantity, squared. And again, we take 3 squared is 9, and y to the 4th squared is y to the 8th. Now we can directly use this rule for factoring the difference of two squares, and we get 4x to the 1 fifth minus 3y to the 4th times 4x to the 1 fifth plus 3y to the 4th, and there's our factorization. And looking at example C, where we have to do factoring of a quadratic trinomial that requires substitution first. So we're going to let x equal a plus 1 just to simplify the look of the trinomial and make it easier for us to see the factoring. So then it becomes x squared minus 3x minus 28. And now we take a look at the factoring. We've got our a term is 1, our c term is negative 28, so we need two numbers that multiply to be negative 28. Our b term is negative 3, so we write that down here. And we see that as we go through the factors of negative 28, we would have 1 times negative 28. That doesn't add to 3. 2 times negative 14. That doesn't add to negative 3. But 4 times negative 7 does add to negative 3 and multiplies to be negative 28. So those are the numbers we want to use in our factoring. So now we have x plus 4 times x minus 7. When the leading coefficient is a 1, then we get to just use the numbers we came up with right in the factorization. Now it's time to substitute back to a, which was what the original trinomial was written in terms of. So this becomes a plus 1 plus 4 times a plus 1 minus 7, and then we simplify each of those factors and we get a plus 5 times a minus 6, and that is our final factorization. Example D. First order of business on this example is to get a common denominator. And we can see that that common denominator would be x to the 4th. So this is going to become 12x to the 4th minus 16x squared minus 3 over x to the 4th. And of course, what we just did was we multiplied the 12 by x to the 4th over x to the 4th. we multiplied 16 over x squared by x squared over x squared, and the 3 already had x to the fourth in the denominator. So now we can factor the numerator separately. And again, we can do a substitution here if we want to have something a little simpler to begin with. So we can think of this, if we let a equal x squared, then the 12x to the fourth becomes 12a squared. 16x squared becomes 16a, and minus 3. And now we can just work on factoring this one in this little bit simpler form, and then remember to substitute back to the x squared. Now, we know that we're going to need two numbers that multiply to be negative 36, because we've got 12 times negative 3 gives us the negative 36. And they have to add to be negative 16. And we can go through the process here in an organized way, keeping track of our factors. If we try 1 and negative 36, that does not add to be negative 16. We can try 2 and negative 18. Ah, there it is. So we have a positive 2 and a negative 18. And of course, those two numbers tell us how to break up this middle term here. So this middle term is going to become plus 2a minus 18a. Now the first term, of course, 12a squared, comes right down. And the last term, minus 3, comes right down. Now we're going to factor these two at a time. We can pull out a 2a from the first two terms, and we will have left 6a plus 1. From the second two terms, we can factor out a minus 3, and we can see that we would have left 6a plus 1. And we always want to double check our factoring at this point. If we do 2a times 6a, that gives us 12a squared. 2a times 1 gives us 2a. Minus 3 times 6a gives us minus 18a. Minus 3 times a 1 gives us a minus 3. So we know that we've done our factoring correctly. So now we see that we have a 6a plus 1 here, and we have a 6a plus 1 here. So we're going to factor that out. And now we have 6a plus 1 that we've factored out times what's left, 2a minus 3. Now remember, we did this substitution where we let a equal x squared. So we have to substitute back for that now. And we've got 6 times x squared plus 1 times 2 times x squared minus 3. And now we can bring that back into the numerator over here. So the numerator is now 6x squared plus 1 times 2x squared minus 3. The denominator is still x to the fourth, and this is the factorization. Example E, we're going to be factoring the difference of two cubes. So let's review the formula for that. If we had x cubed minus y cubed, that would factor out to be x minus y times x squared plus xy plus y squared. So now if we take our given problem, b cubed minus 27, the first thing we want to write it as the difference of two cubes. So we would have b to the third minus 3 to the third. Now we can directly apply this formula and we get b minus 3 times b squared plus, now what we have to do is the product of the two terms, so the product would be 3b plus the last term squared, so 3 squared. And of course we can write 3 squared as 9. So in our last step here we have b minus 3 times b squared plus 3b plus 9, and that's the factorization for this problem. Example F, what we're going to demonstrate here is factoring by grouping. When you have four terms like this, what you want to do is look at them two at a time. So if we look at these first two terms, we see that the coefficient that we could factor out is a 4, and the variable we can factor out is an a, and what we would have left then is 3a minus 2. Now in the second pair, we see that our coefficient we can factor out is a 5, the variable we can factor out is b, and what we would have left then would be 3a minus 2. Now you always want to double check your factoring before you move on. So if we take a look at this, 4a times 3a is 12a squared. We've got 4a times a negative 2 would be a negative 8a. 5b times 3a is 15ab. 5b times a negative 2 is negative 10b. So we're good to go. We notice now that both of these terms have a 3a minus 2. So that's what we'll factor out next. So now we factor out the 3a minus 2, and what we have left will be 4a plus 5b, and that is the factorization for this problem.